Men are not acting like men at all. Have you guys ever seen male rompers? That is a disgusting, horrible thing. And that should never happen, okay? Men should not wear rompers. If you've been on TikTok, this is just an example. For the people who don't know what that is, TikTok is this new social media app that is basically full of high school and middle school kids who make these very vain videos of themselves. And you see men who are like 16, or not men, boys who are 16, 17 years old, dancing to songs, lip syncing, and they have earrings on, and they do their hair so pretty. I mean, I do mine too, but it's different. It's different. It's different. But it's like, this is the generation of men that we're raising. We're raising men who do not feel like men. If we don't have men to stand up for the values that we believe in America, then this country is really lost. We have feminine men who are going to be the future of this country. And that's a big deal, because right now in America, you have men, young men, I think up to the age of 26, are killing themselves at a rate that is 5 times more than young women. It's the highest suicide rates of young men ever recorded. And that's a terrible thing. Young men are no longer getting jobs. They're not getting married. They're staying at home. They're watching porn. They're playing tons and tons of video games. And listen, those things are not so bad when you're doing it in moderation, you're a younger guy. But when you're graduated from college and you're still living at your parents' place and you're not going out and looking for a date, you are playing video games all day, doing any of these sorts of things, not getting a job, not wanting to get married, that makes you sad. Your life is not fulfilled. They also don't have any religion in them. These young men, I mean, I went to CU Boulder, as you guys know, if you guys have been there, or I mean, even here probably at DU, I mean, they're godless places. The university is a godless place, as you guys probably know. And I'll talk about this a little bit in the ending, but that's a real big deal. That's a real big deal when people don't have any sort of value or moral system to follow. And then they turn to these other things. And I know this is how young men feel. I know that young men feel that they have no purpose. They feel like there's not a whole lot of stuff that they can do. They get shamed by the left. They're told that they're terrible people. And I know this is the case because I was one of these young guys, right? But when I was talking about my experience at CU Boulder as a young man, you know, I felt like I had no purpose. I partied all the time. I skipped my classes. I wasn't doing very well in the things that I was doing because I didn't really feel like I had a real direction. The left and the people who I thought I was supposed to follow were not pushing me into a direction that I thought was anything for me, you know? And this is for young women feel this way too, but especially for my men out there, you know, you know how it feels. And so the number one thing that changed for me, well, two things. The two things that changed for me. The first one was reconnecting with my family. My family is here. But I wasn't very close with them, and I felt, you know, a lot of times, you know, family values aren't that important. I'm doing my own thing. I'm up in college. It doesn't matter. And, you know, you really realize how important family is. How important family values are. The lack of family values right now in America. I mean, I live in LA. The divorce rate is, I think, close to 70% in LA. You know, people are growing up without fathers, without families. And that's a huge deal. So for me, reconnecting with my family and realizing that these are the most important people in my life and really putting them first instead of myself being selfish was a huge deal for me. And if you're feeling lost at all, try reconnecting with your family too. It'll really change your life. The second thing was putting happiness over enjoyment. And that's another big deal. The thing that, I was doing things that were very enjoyable. I would sit at home, I'd watch a lot of TV, I'd go out and party, and those things brought me a lot of temporary enjoyment. I was hanging out with people who weren't great people, and those things brought me a lot of enjoyment, but they didn't bring me any real happiness. I didn't feel happy, you know, the next morning, obviously. And so putting the things that brought you happiness above enjoyment is another way to totally change your life. Right now, people in America, their priorities are all wrong. We're putting the things that bring us enjoyment above the things that bring us happiness.
Thank you for watching this video. To help keep PragerU videos free, please consider making a tax-deductible donation.